Hello, my name is Shariah Garcia and this is my lifestyle project. For this project, I took the approach of cutting my water use by 50% and not eating meat or driving my car for 3 days. The weekend before beginning my diet for the lifestyle project, I researched which non-meatless foods are highest in protein. I then completed my list of groceries and began my shopping trip. My purchases included nuts, yogurt, oatmeal, canned beans, and protein bars. I would say that meat is a high component of my diet and what I eat day to day. This made it hard to know which foods to prepare together in order to make a good meal. During my dieting, I ate either oatmeal or yogurt with berries in the morning and peanut butter and jelly sandwiches for lunch. I went to the dining hall for dinner like I usually do and ate the vegetarian options they offered, such as veggie bowls and pasta. During this project, I was very surprised with what I learned on the relationship between meat consumption and its contribution to one's ecological footprint. For example, that eating 1 kilogram of beef produces the same emissions as driving 63 miles. Not only does meat produce carbon emissions, but it also requires an insane amount of water to be made. One hamburger itself needs 660 gallons of water to be produced. Secondly, in my project, I cut my water usage by 50%. To do this, I started by timing my normal daily shower. This time came out to be about 25 minutes. During project week, I timed myself again, but this time I made sure not to exceed 12 minutes. This was not as hard as I thought it would be. I washed my hair first thing instead of last, and I waited until I was out of the shower to wash my face and brush my teeth. I often do these things in the shower out of pure laziness. By cutting my shower down by 50%, I went from using 225 liters of water per shower to 108 liters of water. Taking faster showers is definitely something I'm going to incorporate into my daily life, especially living in a state that is prone to droughts. Lastly, I cut down my emissions by cutting out all fossil fuel transportation. The average person emits 4.6 metric tons of carbon dioxide per year of driving. Fossil fuel is the leading cause of pollution in the United States. By not driving for 3 days, I reduced my total emissions by 37,806 grams of CO2, according to the national average. At first, I thought this was going to be the most difficult aspect of my project, because I normally drive every time I go somewhere. But it was actually not difficult at all. I discovered the town of Chico is a lot smaller than you would believe. Most of the time, if I needed to go anywhere, I would walk. If I felt like it was too far to walk, luckily I was able to borrow my roommate's bicycle. I feel that biking is one of the best ways to cut down on your carbon footprint while still being able to get where you need to go efficiently and timely. Not to mention that it's good exercise and it's good for your health. Even if, for example, you live in an area that you felt was too far to access important places such as work or school, there's always the option of public transportation. By using public transportation, such as the bus, you can greatly offset your carbon emissions by riding with others going to the same area. I feel as though I have learned a lot about how I directly affect the atmosphere I live in. After this project, I intend to incorporate these practices into my daily life. Overall, this project was very beneficial.